Salmon leave the river as tiny little juveniles, go out to the ocean, live there 2, 3, 4, 5 years, and then come back to the stream that they started from. So that fidelity to place, I think, touches us. Maybe at a very subconscious level, it makes us all think about what it means to come home again.
The paradigm for 100 years has been hatchery fish, any place you could put hatchery fish because of the benefit. When the natural population started really declining and the impact of the Endangered Species Act, it suddenly began to be recognized that there's both conservation and harvest goals that society expected from people that manage natural resources.
The objective of hatchery reform is to provide fisheries without impairing our wild fish populations.
A lot of our hatchery reform projects are around construction projects to improve fish passage at our hatcheries.
We are using scientific tools to help reduce the impacts of hatcheries on salmon and to make salmon better. We have dietitians who work on diet, physiologists that help us learn how the salmon should grow better in hatcheries. We have pathologists and veterinarians that monitor the health of salmon in hatcheries and treat them if something goes wrong. We have geneticists who look at the genetic characteristics of the hatcheries, engineers and ecologists who help design better places for salmon to live in hatcheries. When you actually step back, it's an amazing amount of scientific work that's being done to make hatcheries better.
So we're using genetic monitoring to determine the amount of genetics that are being transferred from our hatchery programs to the wild populations.
Hatcheries are the engine that support fishing economies up and down the coast. They also support recovery and allow us to mark fish, distinguishing them from wild fish. In some cases, this allows hatchery fish to be selectively caught or prevented from spawning with wild fish. Hatcheries can also help prevent wild populations from going extinct. Hatchery reform is about making the network of hatcheries, harvest, hydropower, and habitat restoration work together towards recovery. We cannot have one without the other.